So the bleeding that you bleed after you just give birth, that's going to be reduced when you breastfeed, because the breastfeeding is helping the uterus to contract, shrink, and push out that extra blood. What's up, beautiful people? Welcome to another exciting episode of New Mom with Dr. O. You already know. And guess what? Today we have an exciting topic planned. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy. If you are a mom that has chosen to breastfeed, like I always say, kudos to you. You're the best mom in the world. And for those that haven't yet decided whether or not they want to breastfeed, or they're still confused, or they're still weighing their options, today I'm going to help you decide, right? I'm going to be telling you the pros and cons of breastfeeding, and at the end of this video you decide what you want to do, if you want to breastfeed or you don't want to breastfeed. And if you do decide, whatever your decision ends up being, tell me in the comment section, how did you arrive at that decision and why, right? And did this video influence your decision in any way? I'll definitely like to know, so don't forget to drop it in the comment section. Okay, so let's get right to it. Of course, with anything, it's always good to talk about the good part before the bad part, because I'm an advocate for breastfeeding. So I'm going to tell you everything you stand to gain if you breastfeed your baby. Not just for your baby, but for you as well. Breastfeeding is so beneficial. Like, it's such a big deal. It's, for me, there's everything to gain and almost nothing to lose, right? Both for you and the baby, there's benefits for you, there's benefits for your baby. So tell me, why would you not want to do this? Okay? So the number one pro of breastfeeding, that's the number one benefit or the number one advantage of breastfeeding, is the fact that it is readily available anytime, anywhere, any day. And you don't have to pay for it. It is free of charge. Like, it's literally free of charge, right? Breast milk is there with you. Nobody can steal it away, right? It doesn't spoil as long as it remains in the natural habitat where it's supposed to be. It doesn't spoil, right? It's the right temperature. It's the right consistency. It's the right taste. It's just perfect for baby. It's the perfect natural food for the baby, right? You don't have to take your time and say, oh, you want to prepare breast milk, or you have to go and boil warm water before you prepare breast milk, or you need feeding bottle, or you need to bring something. So your baby is crying and baby is hungry and you have to take like 5 minutes out of your time to go and wash your hands and prepare something. No. Baby is hungry. Okay, that's not a problem. Put baby, bring out breast and give baby food. So the next advantage of breastfeeding that I'm about to talk about, this one is for my fit fam people, you know, you all that like to keep fit, looking fresh and slim and all that. Let me tell you something. If you want to lose weight fast after you give birth, then your number one expo is breastfeeding, right? Breastfeeding helps you to lose weight much faster after childbirth. Like, don't you know that making breast milk, right, or maintaining your milk supply, it takes work. Like, you have to burn calories to do that. So breastfeeding actually helps you to burn those extra calories that you might not have had time to do, you know. Normally they say, oh, you have to exercise, you have to do more routine. Even just sitting down and breastfeeding, at least you burn some calories. So trust me, it's an easy one. Like, it's an easy option, it's an easy way out. If you want to just intensify your weight loss efforts, you want to get back to that full baby shape soon enough, then start breastfeeding your baby today. You will mean your baby will be happy and so will you. Another advantage that breastfeeding has in a lot of women, for some reason not every woman experiences this well, maybe if you're not continuously breastfeeding, but for most women, if you are constantly breastfeeding, right, that means you don't just stop after the exclusive stage of 6 months, but you continue to 1 year or even the recommended 2 years. Yes, breastfeeding is recommended for 2 years, right? Of course, from after 6 months, you begin to supplement breast milk with other things, right? But breastfeeding should continue for at least 2 years. If you can't do 2 years, then you can do one, but the longer the better, right? Because there's so many benefits, like I'm about to tell you in this video. And one of them is that for as long as you breastfeed, you can get pregnant for most women, right? So breastfeeding serves as a form of contraception, right? And personally, this is how it works for me, for both of my pregnancies. For as long as I was breastfeeding, I was not really on any other sort of contraception and I did not get pregnant. But the moment I stopped breastfeeding, literally the next menstrual cycle, I got pregnant 2 times. So trust me when I say it works. If you're not too sure of the cycle, if the cycle is one that is not regular, right, don't try this at home. You might want to use breastfeeding, but you can just supplement it with another form of contraception, right, just to be on the safe side. But trust me, breastfeeding works like magic. I've tried it before and I'm a living testimony, so I can tell you it is awesome for contraception, right? So basically, how this works is that the breastfeeding actually stops your period. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that. Not only are you not going to get pregnant, but you also stop seeing your period. Like, oh my god, that's like heaven. You stop seeing your period and you're not on menopause. Like, you stop seeing your period. You don't have to deal with that period thing every month. Like, you'll be happy, your partner will be happy. And trust me, this is not a fantasy. This has happened to me. My two pregnancies, the whole time I was breastfeeding, I did not see my period for one day. Of course, the moment I stopped, my period came back immediately. But the whole time I was breastfeeding, I never saw my period. And I breastfed for 18 months for both babies. Yeah, I wanted to go the whole 2 years, but I couldn't cope. I tried my best, but trust me, if I make it 2 years, all the better for you. So you see, breastfeeding is so awesome. Like, free contraception, you don't have to go to the doctor. You save money on sanitary pads because you don't have to see your period, as long as you're continuously breastfeeding. You know, not the one that you see your breastfeeding and you only breastfeed your baby once a week or once every 3 days. No, even if you're not able to feed regularly, like put your baby to breast, make sure you're pumping milk for your baby. Trust me, you will see no periods and you wouldn't get pregnant. The win-win situation as far as I'm concerned. Another thing that breastfeeding does for you, right, especially after you've just given birth, is when you are breastfeeding your baby, right, what it does is it stimulates your womb to start shrinking back to the normal size, right? So if you just give, when you just give birth, if you start breastfeeding immediately, you will notice that as your baby is sucking, you are feeling some kind of cramps in your uterus. That's because the sucking is making the uterus shrink to the normal size. So that cramping is your uterus actually shrinking. So every time baby is sucking, you might feel like those kind of tiny cramps. That's a good sign, because even as the uterus is shrinking, it's helping you to push out all that retained products of conception, right? All the blood and everything is pushing it out of your womb. That way, it's even going to reduce your postpartum bleeding. So the bleeding that you bleed after you just give birth, that's going to be reduced when you breastfeed, because the breastfeeding is helping the uterus to contract, shrink, and push out that extra blood. So trust me, if you're in a situation, if you don't breastfeed, yours is not going to contract as fast, right? Because there's nothing to stimulate it to do so. So you might want to consider that so you can also get over that phase as soon as possible. And the last one I want to mention, if you are someone that likes to travel like me, that loves going on vacation, going everywhere, touring the world, then this is a big deal for you, because when you are breastfeeding your baby and you have to travel with your baby, at least you don't have to worry about formula feeds. You don't have to worry about feeding bottle. You don't have to worry about carrying flask with hot water. You don't have to worry about, I didn't even have hot water on the plane. And where am I going to wash my feeding bottle? Where am I going to sterilize my feeding bottle? You know, yadi yadi yadi. All those things you don't have to worry about, because you're just giving your baby breast milk. The only thing you'll be worrying about is, okay, am I wearing my nursing bra? Do I have enough nursing bra? Do I have enough breast pads to change in case I get shot and all those kind of things? Those are the little things you worry about. And trust me, that is nothing compared to having to carry a big bag of formula feeds, water, and all that around. But plus airport checks, when you're carrying warm water around, you're carrying formula feeds and all that thing, every time you'll be stopping to check, let's make sure the baby food they're carrying, right? Baby food is allowed on board, but they always need to check it at every stop. So that's probably really frustrating and time consuming. Why go through that stress where you can just bring out your breast and give baby food? Trust me, you should consider it. But let me just sound a note of warning for breastfeeding moms, right? This one, I'm telling you, is from experience. Please, please, and please. You see, as you're breastfeeding your baby, you can have this habit of just sticking to one breast. You know, somehow you tend to have a favorite breast because there's one that's more comfortable for you to carry baby, maybe your right side or your left side, depending on you. So don't stay in the habit of only feeding the baby on one side and neglecting the other side. For your own good, because if you do this, one breast is going to be smaller than the other, or one will be bigger than the other. So you have disproportionately sized breasts, and it will take a while to correct that. And trust me, you don't want that. I'm telling you this out of experience. This happened in my first pregnancy. I can't even remember if it was the right or the left side. I was always feeding on one side because I just felt like, yes, this is just the most comfortable side. This is how I like to hold my baby, so no stress, right? And the baby too tends to like that side because it's really like that side. So I just noticed that one side was always bigger than the other, and it was even becoming noticeable, like it was becoming all this. It was pretty embarrassing. So make sure that you are alternating sides regularly. If you feed on this side, change to this side. Feed on this side, consciously make sure you are using both sides, because so that the breasts will remain the same size. You don't want to be having, so that they will not be wondering that what's going on with this breast. So let's talk about how breast milk is good for your baby. Number one, there's something called colostrum. That's the first breast milk that comes out when you just give birth. So not your normal breast milk is like whitish or off-white in color, but this colostrum is a bit yellowish, right? If you are actually someone that pumps, you'll see that that one is really yellow, right, compared to the color of your regular breast milk. And that colostrum is the milk that comes out the first few days when you just start breastfeeding, right? After a while it becomes regular white. That colostrum is very, very important because it contains antibodies from your own body. Antibodies are things that help your baby to fight infection. They are part of your baby's blood cells that helps to fight infection. Now you are transferring your own antibodies through breast milk to your baby, right? That's passive immunity. So that means that for those first few days of life, your baby gets antibodies from you to help your baby fight infection. So your baby is protected from all kinds of infections during that first few days when they're getting their breast milk from you. If you allow your baby to miss this, how is the baby going to be protected? Do you want to be relying on antibiotics at that young age? To make sure you give your baby breast milk, let your baby have that colostrum breast milk so they can have that antibodies protecting them for those first few weeks, protect them against bacteria, viruses, you know, different types of infection. Very, very important. Another good thing about breast milk for babies is, just similar to what I just said, it helps them to build their immunity, right? So it boosts their immune system so they're able to fight and build their immunity against infection. So it's very important because at a young age, babies and children tend to fall sick often, right? Because they're very vulnerable and their immune system is not yet well developed, right? So you breastfeeding your baby actually helps. From experience, you see that breastfed babies fall sick less often than formula fed babies. So it's very important that you give your child that boost, you know, so that they don't have to fall sick all the time. If you are protecting your child against infection, your child is not going to be falling sick all the time, and that will even save your time having to care for a sick child. Trust me, it can be stressful. It can really be stressful and, you know, draining, and you don't want this to be you. So just make sure that you're giving your baby that immune booster, right, which is breast milk, the natural immune booster already, right? You don't have to rely on other things. Yeah, you can give other supplements, that's right, but this is the main supplement you need to be giving to your baby, especially those first few days of life, first few 6 months, and if possible even up to 2 years. Trust me, it works. I told you all the benefits, or most of the benefits, about breastfeeding naturally. If you know any more benefits that I haven't mentioned, make sure you write them in the comment section down below so we can all discuss it. But now let me tell you the little disadvantages, because there are a few, and I don't really consider them to be being disadvantages because it's something you can work around. One of the downsides of breastfeeding is the fact that whatever you eat literally goes into your breast milk, right? Whatever you eat goes into the breast milk. It can be good because if you are taking in good nutrients, good food, then your baby is getting good food. Studies have shown that, like, even the flavor of the breast milk is affected by what you eat, right? Eat nice foods, breast milk tastes nice, you know, those kind of things. So, but in the same way, if you take something bad, it goes to your baby. So, for example, if you take alcohol, alcohol is going to your baby. If you take certain drugs that shouldn't be given to babies, some of them are actually excreted in the breast milk. So they go to your baby too. So in that, when you're breastfeeding, you have to be careful about the type of drug you take. You can't take just any drug. Every time you're breastfeeding, make sure anytime your doctor prescribes the drug for you, you tell the doctor, I'm currently breastfeeding, is it okay to take this? If they say, oh yes, it's safe for breastfeeding moms, go ahead and take it. Sometimes you forget to ask your doctor, read the instructions. Does this say it's okay for breastfeeding? If it's okay, then you can go ahead. If it's not, then be careful, because whatever you take, the baby takes. So you want to be very careful about what you eat. The next downside of breastfeeding is that baby has to follow you literally everywhere you go. Well, not necessarily, because you can actually breast pump, right? So breastfeeding is easier when you just have to feed directly, like you're feeding the baby directly, because you don't have to go through any stress and everything, you're just feeding the baby. But for example, if you have to go to work, you have to attend an event where you can't take your child or something like that, or you have to travel for whatever reason. So that's one of the downsides, that is an on-demand food. So when you're not there, then you have to make sure that it's available for your baby by other means. So breast pump, get an electric breast pump or a manual breast pump, whichever one suits you. Then this last downside is the fact that you can't really measure how much your baby is eating with breast milk. Unlike if you are feeding your baby in a feeding bottle, right, you would know that, okay, your baby is taking 100 meals, your baby is taking 150 meals, okay, he's taking 150 meals now, he's eating well and all that. But breast milk, you can't measure how much your baby is sucking. However, like I said, there's always a way to work around it. If it gets to a situation where you must measure your baby's feet, use a breast pump and bottle feed your baby with breast milk. So you see, there's really no excuse or disadvantage for you not to want to breastfeed your baby. See, the purpose of this my whole video is to convince you that breastfeeding is good and you should breastfeed your baby. Because it's not only good for your baby, it's good for you as well. So tell me, after everything I've said, why won't you want to breastfeed? If you've enjoyed this video so far, please don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to this channel. Share this video with anyone you think might need to see this. Like I always say, being a new mom can be a bit overwhelming, but trust me, your kids are totally worth it. See you next week.